You don't need to look it to become it. But if you can behave it, you will become it. Oh my God, you are not getting what I'm talking about. You are a pastor, yeah, you don't yet have a car. Go and get a car key and begin to shake it when you are moving. You know what I'm talking about now? Are you getting me? Papa, we look at, thank God Reverend Kingsley is here. Papa, we look at me and Reverend Kingsley. We want to go out. He said, go and bring out the Jeep that we used to go out. We are actually going to take a taxi. You dare not come, you dare not ask him which one. As he said, bring out the Jeep, you must move. You must move. Are you following me now? Can I tell you something, ladies and gentlemen? This is the time for you to begin to see where you want your ministry to be in the next 5 years. Oh my God, oh my God. Listen, look at me. When you begin to develop vision for your ministry, you will not have time for gossip. Your friends will reduce. Your prayer level will increase. Nobody will beg you to study scripture. You see, Papa, it is scripture. It is because of the vision that is propelling him, that is pushing him. Ayadush Kapaya. Sit down. Sit down. What is vision? Vision is the definition of your destination. Is the definition of your destination. What is vision? Vision is a clear picture of your future. The quality of your life is determined by the state of your mind. What you visualize is what you actualize. In Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18, the Bible says, where there is no vision, people perish. And someone also said, where there are no people, vision also perish. Ladies and gentlemen, your heart account, your heart is bigger than your bank account. One day Papa was sitting on the chair. We used to sit down with bench. There were no plastic chairs. He was sitting on the bench. And he looked at me and Rebecca. He said, God told me I will be a millionaire. I will play with money. At times we'll go behind. I just pray he's not watching me now so that he doesn't catch me. At times we'll go behind and like, man, I post to save. When Trek come here, he said we'll play with money. How? Mary said, how can these things be? And the angel said, it's not going to be by your strength or by your power. The Spirit of God shall overshadow you. The Spirit of God is looking for your vision to overshadow. I wish I can take time to explain something here. Your imagination set the pace of your destination. Pastor Emma, look at this. In Genesis chapter 11, some people came together. They said, let us build a tower that will reach up to heaven. You know what the Bible said? It said, these people is one. That is a grammatical somersault. How did they become one? They became one in hearts, in vision. You know what the Bible said in verse 6? It said, let us go and stop them. Because the way they are going now, nothing can stop them from achieving what they have what? Imagine to do. Not what they plan to do. Not what they decided to do. What they imagine to do. Which means, in their heart, they have completed the Tower of Babel. Even God knew that the way these people are going, in their imagination, they have seen the finished tower. God said, what? Listen, the spiritual controls the physical. If you are a scientist here, do you know that the television you watch, what you call the color television, the colors that you don't see in television, they are more than the colors that you see. Am I correct, scientist? The colors that your eyes can see are few. The colors that you can't see in the color television, there are millions. That is how the spiritual realm is. If you want to get into the spiritual realm, you need to see something. You need to imagine something. Are you what I'm talking about? Because anything you imagine, he said, you have heard. Okay. Jesus will always say, Moses in his law said, but I say unto you. He did not call the commandment God's law. If you check it, Jesus never called the commandment God's law. He called it Moses' law. He even said the law was given by who? Moses. Grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. Do you know why? Moses was the first to receive the commandment. And Moses was also the first to break the commandment. Abraham talking about, he was the first to receive it, and he was the first to break it. Look at what God did when he broke the commandment. God said, I gave you the commandment on a platter of gold, but the second one, you are the one that is going to cut the stone. Moses went and Moses began to cut the stone. When Moses finished cutting the stone, initially God said, you will cut, I will write. But when Moses finished cutting, God said, sit down and begin to write. While Moses was writing, all the things that God told Moses were not all the things that Moses wrote down in the second commandment. He summarized them. Pastor Ma, you are a theologian. That is why I said, you have heard that it has been said, thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say unto you, if you look unto a woman to lust after her, you have committed adultery already. Why did he say that? What God was actually telling Moses in that place was that if a man look at her, he has committed. But Moses said, thou shalt not commit adultery. In other words, God was trying to explain to us, sin does not become sin when you commit it. Sin becomes sin when it's conceived. Imagine in your